Well, the doctor is in, and today the topic is blood clots. They're clumps that occur when the blood hardens from a liquid to a solid, and blood clotting can be a good thing or a bad thing, like the recent hospitalization we saw of Secretary of State Hillary Clinton for a blood clot between her brain and her skull. Dr. Scott Ackerman is one of the First Coast's leading doctors. He's here today to talk about the symptoms and treatments available. Thank you so much, Dr. Ackerman, for being here. And that was
Thanks,
in the news
Casey.
A lot. And it still is in the news as people are trying to figure out exactly what happened and what her condition is all about. But let's back it up to just to the starting point of all of this. And what exactly is a blood clot?
Well, we have a mechanism in our bodies to help us, help protect us to cause our blood to clot. When you get cut or your skin gets punctured, you don't want to bleed forever. You want something to protect you and to keep you from bleeding to death. So our blood clots, and that's a normal, natural thing. This process is triggered by what we call thrombogenic substances. There's substances in the skin and in the walls of the blood vessels. So when they're torn, when the blood vessel's torn or the skin's torn, these substances come in contact with blood and it creates a clot. And that clot saves our life from bleeding. Sometimes if there is a abnormality, if these substances get in contact with blood when we don't want it to, you can get a clot that forms in an artery or a vein. And these clots can break off from the wall of the artery or vein and go to another part of the body and cause a pulmonary embolism. It can cause heart attacks. It can cause strokes.
So let's talk specifically about Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's condition. What kind of clot did she have? What happened? What was that all about?
Well, I'm not her physician, so I'm not exactly sure. But what I saw on the news was an unusual clot that she had that formed between her brain and her skull. And so, you know, your skull isn't very elastic. And so when you have a clot that forms in there, it can cause pressure on the brain because it can't push out on the bone in your skull. And that pressure on the brain would cause interruption of blood flow to the brain. And it could make her give you a headache or so, cause some lightheadedness. She had a fall. We saw that on the news. And so she probably had a mild concussion. Also, she had the flu. And those two things combined puts one at risk for having a clotting disorder or to develop a blood clot in that area.
So then what are some of the other risks that if someone's watching right now that they should be aware of for blood clots?
Well, blood clots can occur either in the arteries. Those are the vessels that take blood away from the heart to the rest of the body, or the veins, those vessels that take blood back to the heart. So, and the etiology of them is different, a little bit different for the two of them. Arterial clots, and these are clots that form in the aorta or in the coronary arteries. These are associated with high blood pressure, high cholesterol levels, diabetes, smoking, having a family history. What happens is in all of these diseases, you get plaque formation inside the arteries, what we call atherosclerosis. And this plaque formation causes disturbance in the flow of the blood. And this disturbance in the flow of the blood causes turbulent flow inside the blood vessels. And it causes some small micro tears and abrasions within those vessels. And these thromboembolic agents thrombogenic agents rather, get in contact with the blood and cause a clot to form near these plaques. And then, as I said before, these clots leave the wall and go to other parts of the body and cause problems. In the veins, however, which is more commonly in the legs, sometimes in the arms, these clots are caused by immobility. When people have surgery, have hip surgery, you're laid up in bed for a few days. And actually, with any surgery, when you're laid up after surgery, you're at increased risk for developing a clot in the veins of the legs, what we call deep vein thromboses, and mainly just because sluggish flow because you're not moving a lot. There's also some genetic errors that can cause defects in the clotting mechanism that'll lead to venous clots as well.
So then what are some of the symptoms then if someone is experiencing? What do you think that Hillary Clinton, again, I know you're obviously not her physician, but what do you think the symptoms she suffered from? I mean, was it an excruciating headache or what led her to go to the hospital to know that she even had this clot?
Well, when you get what we call a subdural hematoma or a blood clot between the brain and the skull, the symptoms associated with that are usually headaches because it's pushing pressure on the fluid around the skull. Fluid around the brain, rather, and pressure on the brain, so you get this headache that's localized to one side of the head or the other, or wherever the clot is. It's going to be localized there, and also you can get a little bit lightheaded. You know, when you're not getting good blood circulation to the brain, you get a little bit lightheaded. So I'm sure those were the kind of symptoms she was having that led to X-rays and CAT scans and those sort of things that found it. But if you get clots that form in the veins, the legs, for instance, you'll get it prevents the blood from flowing back towards the heart, and so you'll get swelling of the leg. And so if someone has swelling in one leg but not the other, that might be related to a clot in the vein of the leg. If it's in the arm, you'll get swelling of the arm. If that swelling's too much, it'll get red and you'll have some paralysis or weakness of that limb. If a blood clot breaks loose and goes into the lungs, it'll cause an embolism in the lungs, and patients experience shortness of breath or chest pain from that. If it's an arterial blood clot in the coronary artery that breaks loose in the coronary artery, which is an artery that feeds the heart, it'll block the coronary artery and block blood flow to the heart, and that's a heart attack. If you have a blood clot that leaves a vein or an artery and goes to the brain, that's what we call a stroke. And that stroke, the symptoms of that are numbness, loss of movement in one side of the body or the other, sometimes the face, vision changes, a seizure is a symptom of a stroke as well. So any of these symptoms should make you alert. See your physician, make sure you don't have a blood clot. If you have a clot in your leg or somewhere, you can treat it and you can prevent it from leaving the leg and causing a real serious problem. So when we find them early, we can treat them properly and prevent long-term permanent damage.
All right. Thanks so much, Dr. Ackerman. We appreciate you being
Thank you, Casey.
Always and for sponsoring the segment. And Dr. Ackerman is with us every Friday. And next week, we're going to be chatting about cancer symptoms women are likely to ignore. And for questions regarding today's topic or any other health questions that you might have, you can visit firstcoastoncology.com and confidentially submit your questions to Ask the Doctor. We'll